Welcome back in renewable and sustainable energy. This is module 3, which is about wind, hydro and otic energy. Week number 8, wind energy system. We'll discuss wind energy this week. Now, let me start from wind energy principles. So I will talk about the principal resources terminology, and then we move to power and energy and wind turbine design. We conclude in using design technical and economical example. First of all, wind represents air in motion, and it's occurred because of our planet covered with soil and water, and they are different in heat capacity. Okay, as example, the land on day it's observe more heat than water and faster, so the air gets heated and it's go up because its weight reduced, and the cold and heavier air on the water will come to take over the place, and then we have movement of this air. So this is a reflection of solar energy at the end, and there is interest in Oman to have large plants. This is what's published in media a few years back, talking about Oman plans to have 200 million wind energy projects, and there is one already there is implemented with the help of Masdar Abu Dhabi with 50 megawatt wind in Al Mazyuna, and there are some few projects, new projects coming in 2023, planned to come. These in Ras Al Had or in Duqm, in Ja'lan bin Bani Ali, and in other places to the south. 400 megawatt. Now, the history of wind energy started from, let's talk about 5,000 years back, where people in Egypt, in Persia, in Iraq, and they use it for sealing in sail in rivers, and also for grinding wheat and other corn. Also, Holland people wanted to develop these, let me say, technology to be used in windmill. And also, if we back to 1920, American Colonel use it to generate electricity, small wind turbine in rural area. Now, the power available, mechanical power available in the wind can be captured by a turbo generator to generate electricity. This is the main application used today. And as I mentioned in the past, it's used for grinding, pumping water, or let me say used in sail in the by ships in the rivers or ocean. Now, what happened is wind is a mechanical energy. Now, it's captured by the blades of the wind turbine, and then it rotates the turbine itself, which is connected to gearbox, and it's rotated generated to generate electricity. This is the main available today by humankind. Now, the wind turbine, as I mentioned, it's have different size, different shapes. It's, let me say, simplified by saying it's the opposite of fan. Fan absorbs electricity to produce wind. The opposite happens in wind turbine. It's rotate by the wind itself mechanically to produce electrical energy. Now we have mainly two type of wind turbines. We have horizontal axis and vertical axis. Horizontal axis, from the name is horizontal, is rotating horizontally, while vertical axis is like equator style. I will show you. And there is also modern type of wind turbine. As you can see here in this turbine, is the horizontal one, and this third one is the vertical one. Okay, we have here the tower, here the base, here the turbine, gear, generator, and these are the blades. The from here to here represent the swept area. While you can see here this turbine, vertical turbine, mainly today people are using horizontal turbine electricity in large applications. Now, the turbine components, as we mentioned, that it contain blades and rotor were connected. This is the blades, these are the blades, and this is the shaft connect to a gearbox, and the gearbox to to increase the speed going to the generator and generate electricity, and it is taken to the load. Okay, now when we put these wind turbines together, many wind turbines together, to make a wind plant, we call it wind farm. Okay, it generates a huge amount of energy and feed to the grid, which is grid connected type. There are some so small turbines could be used to provide electricity for homes or business. These are small or medium. Now we're talking about large turbine up to 5 mega, not kilo, I'm not talking about kilowatt, 5 megawatt, and even today technology improved it to 7, 8, and 10 megawatt available for large scale. Now this is the horizontal, as I mentioned, this is the vertical, this is the vertical. Okay, and when talk about these type of turbines, is large, and it's imagine it is equivalent to horizontal machine, equivalent to 20 store building. Vertical wind turbine, we have limitation of the height, as you know, and but still it's like a football field, I mean large scale token. These are different shape for wind turbine with different vertical or horizontal or something else, or also the base are different. And the new technology is they try to reduce the size and to save the area, okay, and make it more efficient. So they you can see here, they make it like let me say turbo, like turbo, so they increase the speed of the wind. And based on the swept area, okay, we have different size for the wind turbine. As you can see here, these are the size 225 300 500 into 2500. You can see the swept area, the diameter increase, and the energy increase. You see here many wind turbine together to produce what we call wind farm. Now their advantage is it's a free renewable energy source, clean non-polluted electricity, and this can generate huge amount of energy. We can put them on the land, on the shore and offshore, in the ocean or in the sea. And when we use them, we expect that we reduce a huge amount of carbon dioxide could be emitted if we use a fossil fuel generator. So it's reflected on environment. Cost, always we talk about cost, especially when we talk about renewable energy, because we're talking about the capital investment at the beginning. But the last 10 years, let me say, the cost decreased sharply, and it's now competing. Now it is even cheaper, and it's competing, and is take over even nuclear. I remember 2014, it has been announced in the World Renewable Energy Congress in London that the wind turbine take over the nuclear plants. But from the other side, you know that because it's not the speed is different from location to location, and it's not constant. Sometimes it's calm, sometimes it's windy, and so on. So this is one of the disadvantages need to be considered. Now here, before I go further, I would like to compare between the energy profile for United States and for Oman. As you can see here, for United States, we have diversity. We have different source of energy. This is 2017. Natural gas, crude oil, coal, nuclear, wind, biomass, solar, and so. So there is diversity here. But if we come to Oman, we have mainly around 97.5% of our electrical plant using natural gas, and 2.5% using diesel in rural area, as example, Masira and other places. We need to change this. This is important to be changed, okay? Now, for environmental concern, there is some concern because of noise. You know, it's rotating, so it produces noise. With time, with the improvement in technology, this noise starts to be disappeared. It's noiseless now, around to be noiseless. And also its impact, okay? So it's preferable to build it far away from civilization a little bit, okay? So it's not affect people. And also, because of mortality, bat mortality, you know, it's killed birds sometime. So now they make it close. So these almost these three problems have been disappeared. You know, the wind is not, let me say, always rotating there. So sometimes it's calm, as I mentioned. So this is a problem similar to the entertainment for them. The solar energy is not available the whole day. So here we need to have another backup to be used. But it can help by taking some share from the total profile. It's not advisable to store it, but it's advisable to feed it to the grid. Okay, and here are two of my article published in Renewable and Sustainable Energy Review in Elsevier. One of them related to the hybrid PV wind renewable energy in Oman, and the second one talking about renewable energy. I mentioned for these, I discussed these topics and revise the situation in Oman. Now, for wind, we have different type of wind available. We have local wind because of the shape of the land itself. If it is containing mountains and valley, if there is coastal area, and so this will produce different type of wind. And let's talk about mountain and valley. You know, mountain here, this is the mountain, this is the valley. Okay, they on the day they receive different amount of solar energy. As example, the mountain there receive more energy than the valley, which is shaded here. So the air here is hotter than the air here. So we expect that air from the valley going up to the mountain to take over the places released by the hot air. So it's called katabatic wind, or wind coming from the valley, or valley wind. The opposite occurred at night. At night, the mountain cooled faster than valley. So wind blowing from the mountain to the valley. So it's called mountain wind. And between the valley itself, when it's rotating and take different zigzag ways, it's called tunnel effect, which increase the wind. Now, these are, as you can see here, mountains and valley down. You can see here down valleys. Okay, so it's available in nature of Oman. Now, the difference of specific heat of water and soil produce also something similar to mountain and valley. This happened on the day where the air coming from the water, which is cooler than the air on the land, so it's breezing from the sea to the land. As you can see here, this is the beach, this is the ocean, air coming from this, it's called sea breezing. At night, the air, the beach or the land or the soil cooled faster than the water, so that the opposite happened, the wind coming from the land to the water. Now here are statistics about the wind speed. Average wind speed, mainly average, hourly mean average wind speed in meter per second in different location of Oman, different city. As example, you can see here Khasaf, Bremi, Suhar, Ristaq, Muscat, and many other places. It's worth to mention that the wind turbine is efficient if the wind speed above 4 meter per second. And as you can see here, you have many places which have more than 4 meter per second, which show that in Oman is really promising to invest in this technology. Now, to measure the wind, we have wind speed and wind direction. For wind direction, we use what we call it wind van. It shows the direction from when wind came. Okay, and these cubic, as you can see, it's rotate. These cups, three cups, or here you can see here in my weather station in Suhar University on the building, engineering building, you can see here three cups rotating to calculate or to measure the speed of wind. Okay, now wind speed, when it's increased, as you can see the curve here, it's increased, the power generated, you can see here, it's increased also. And there is formula which say that the power of wind is 1 over 2 rho, which is air density, by A, swept area, by cubic V, which is the velocity, cubic of the velocity. Now, we can measure the wind speed by a device which is called anemometer. I show you previous slide, the anemometer. Okay, this is our weather station. This is the anemometer, as you can see here. But in the past, there is a scale, well-known scale called, because of the inventor, which he is Francis Beaufort. He joined the British Royal Navy, and he make a table. He spent most of his life in the sea, okay, in the ships. So he make a table to still till today is used. It's from 0 to 12 scale. Okay, and he gave name for each wind, as example here, calm, light air, light breeze, and so on. For each one, he described it, and as example for calm, when he smoke, he say, when you smoke, it's the smoke rise vertical. This means that the speed is lower than 1 mile per hour. When the smoke drift indicate wind direction, also at the same time, it means that the wind speed in the range of 1 to 3 mile per hour, and so on. Okay, so he make a table. This table is still, even if it is not much accurate, but still used by people today. But it's now cheap to have wind speed, anemometer, wind speed and direction. Okay, now what affect the wind? We have shear and turbulence. Both of them are affecting. For shear, definitely they are related to the type of earth, the type of the level of air, in which level you are up to 10 meter, to 100 meter, 1000 meter, you go up, and this gives different speed, wind speed and direction. Now, wind shear defined to as an abrupt change in wind speed and direction and or direction at different height in the atmosphere. You go up, the speed increase, okay. While turbulence, because this disturbance occurred in the speed or and the direction because of the disordered movement of air molecules. It could be happened because of let me say mixing of warm and cold air together, and we can feel it when turbulence occurred in the airplane when we are traveling, okay. As you can see here, if there is, let me say, trees or house, the wind will disturb. Okay, if there is mountain, it will be disturbed. If there is anything else can disturb it, we can feel it, and it will reduce its effect. The drag, or what we call it aerodynamic drag, simply drag is the force on object that resists its motion through a fluid. And if the fluid is air, we call it aerodynamic drag. It affects the operation of the wind turbine. How we can reduce this effect? We can reduce this by changing the pitch. We can reduce by using fewer, as example here, we have one blade rather than two, three. We reduce the number of blades. We use light weight material. We use smooth surface. We can optimize them to find the best shape for the specific wind characteristics. Now, you know, the speed or wind speed is slow. We're talking about 4 meter per second and plus minus, okay? So while the generator is rotating with high speed, so what we should do, we should use what we call it a gear box, okay? Gear for bearing, where we have large gear and small.